when there were just pauses taking pictures with fans.
Is he a fan in there, by the way?
I would hope so. I don't know, though, but I would imagine there'd be some sort of, like, a little mini fan.
Yeah, cooling device.
Because it, I mean, I'm hot, and I'm not wearing a furry suit, so.
Especially on the third baseline, which is the worst. Oof. Third base in America Park.
Wow. Well, Sparty, we're going to miss you at all the big 4th of July parades, yeah. I guess, but...
But they did say Sparty can still participate in other events,
yeah,
but just not parades.
And I'm also a fan of Johnny Spirit from all parades as well, for obvious reasons.
When was the last time Johnny Spirit was even seen?
I don't know. I've not seen John Spirit in a while, but is he still around, isn't he?
I don't think so. Jonathan Spirit. Unless he, like, biked over the mountains and got past him, the sun,
but they never came back. Which would be a nice possibility.
A suspected serial killer is believed to be on the loose, targeting Detroit women. The story is, you know, definitely not reassuring. Detroit police are
looking for reassuring news this morning. The fact that there might be a serial killer on the loose.
Yeah, this is not it.
Will not go in that direction.
Well, then he's only, you know, if you're not a prostitute, you don't have anything to worry about.
Well, you know, it's hope, but you never know because, you know,
they can spread their wings.
They sure can. So Detroit police are investigating a connection between the killings of at least three different women, all found in abandoned buildings. They are say this killer is a male, and he appears to be targeting sex workers that are in their 50s.
I mean, is that a lie? I'm trying to picture, is that a large demographic, do you think? That doesn't seem like it would be that. I don't know. It's a horrible story all the way around. I'm thought of these poor people who are so financially destitute that they have to work in that industry in their 50s. And then to be lured into an abandoned warehouse, which is unfortunately maybe par for the course sometimes. It's awful.
Yeah, so look out, ladies.
Yeah.
Yep.
And now they're big listeners to the Jamie and Stoney show as well. They get up early every morning to hear you. So
they could be. So
probably saving a lot of lives.
I probably am. Thank you. A Michigan farmer is going to be joining the cast of MTV's The Real World. One, I didn't know The Real World was still running. Shocked me when I found this article, but it's in his 33rd season, which is unbelievable. And now this guy, he's 29 years old. His name is Clint Wright. The picture they have right here on the article, he looks very handsome, and he's from Potterville, and he was selected to be on the show from a Facebook contest.
Right. So he'll be shirts off in the hot tub doing illicit things with random women.
God,
that's kind of the show, isn't it?
That's exactly the show, unless it has changed over the years, but yes, that's it.
I used to be a religious Real World watcher when it was Real World San Francisco with Pedro and Judd and Real World Hawaii. I remember watching.
Where was the one where Puck was?
That was San Francisco, I think it was Puck and Pedro and Judd and the little kid from there.
Yep, so this season is going to take place in Atlanta, and it's actually not going to be broadcast on TV. It now airs on Facebook Watch.
Wonder I haven't been watching.
So has it not been on MTV for a while now?
I don't know. It sounds like it. It's going to start on June 3rd, so you can look out for this Michigan farmer.
Potter, I don't even know where Potterville is. Is that near Lansing? Or?
It's in Eaton County.
That doesn't help me, Heather. I don't know my county.
He was born in Lansing, so neither do I. He was born in Lansing, so perhaps it's out that way.
All right. I'll tell you. I'll look it up.
Where's Eaton County?
You going for like a Ron Allen joke here? Okay.
All right, so A-Rod and J-Lo seem to have a really great relationship. They seem like a match made in heaven. They seem like a little perfect couple, but it could actually be because A-Rod has wanted to date her since he was 22 years old.
Join the club.
Yeah, he actually made a comment back in 1998, and the MLB Network shared the clip that he made when he was just 22 years old, talking about his dream date.
Wow, look at that. Try to go back, and that's almost pre-jam.
crook?
Like make a
bad idea.
Why is it a bad idea?
Everybody loves fortune cookies. They taste good.
No, they really don't. That's where you're wrong. You get a fortune cookie because it's like a novelty that comes with your meal. You don't want to just buy it.
Well, like if they had Girl Scout cookies that were like fortune cookies, people wouldn't be like the worst selling Girl Scout cookies ever. You know what you said right there, Heather, is exactly what my wife said when she poured it.
Easier now because the evaluation is free. Just call 1-800-398.